Hey guys, welcome back. So I have received some messages and comments asking me to do a little bit more keto videos. I don't know how many of you are interested in that, but I'm gonna go ahead and do that since I'm trying to move on to a more lifestyle-y format here in this channel. So I am going to go ahead and do that. I have already had some videos that are keto, so I have a playlist actually of keto videos. So what I'll probably start off with is what do I do as a preparation into going into keto. Now I have been into it for a year and a half, and admittedly have been on and off keto, which has not been good for me because I would shrink and then I would gain it back because I really have no self-discipline. The first time that I went onto it, I lost about 10 pounds in a month's time, which was pretty good. I started off at a weight of 62 kilos and went down to 57 kilos. So that's like 5 kilos, which is about 11 pounds lost right there. But unfortunately, like I said, I don't really have that much discipline in me and self-control, so I ended up like rewarding myself by cheating, and yeah, that didn't really work out well for me. Anyway, I've been on and off keto for the last year and a half and have now decided that, you know what, let's do this. I saw an Instagram post by one of the keto people that I'm following, and she said that keto is like marriage. You can't cheat and expect it to work. Okay, so I'm thinking, you know what, I'm going to commit to doing this. And in fact, what I have done, and this is the first thing that I do whenever I try and go back to being on keto, okay, first thing that I do is get rid of all of the carbs in the house. Or I have not bought rice, which is saying a lot for a Filipino, okay? I have not bought rice for about a year and a half now since I started keto the first time. Haven't bought rice. I haven't, I actually have discovered that I feel really bloated and I feel really lethargic whenever I eat rice. And so I haven't actually gone back to eating rice. Once in a while I would, and when I do, man, it's really bad. It really feels bad, like to the point where I can't sleep because I feel like I'm gonna roll off the bed because I feel so freaking bloated. Okay, so that's one thing that I do, is I get rid of all the carbs in the house, like no breads, which I don't really do breads anymore now. Or anything that's even like mildly carby, especially chocolates, that's out. Even if it's dark chocolate, they say dark chocolate is okay, but I always try to choose the lowest carb content, but still, it stalls me. So I try to remove everything. And when I say I get rid, I don't throw them away, okay? I give them away to friends who are not on keto. Then I would then go shopping or grocery shopping for foods that are keto friendly, like bacon, eggs, sausages, meat and poultry and fish. I would always have some sort of a steak in the house. I would always have some pork mince, some chicken. I would always have some salmon. What else? Yeah, mainly a good mix of protein is what I have. I like to stock up on pork loins as well and pork chops because I like the fatty side of it. Yeah, so that one, and then I always stock up on coconut oil, almond flour, what else? Cheese. Now, this time around, I'm not going to stock up too much on cheese because I feel like cheese also sort of stalls me. And I have also gone away from dairy milk. I am now buying almond milk. In fact, there's one that I really, really like. I'll show you it. Just give me a second. Okay, so this one here, I think that's the brand, AO. I don't know if this is... Oh, it's by Australia's own. That's why it's called AO. I don't know if this is available anywhere else in the world, but this is freaking delicious. It is 99% sugar-free, almond milk, salted caramel flavor, gluten-free, no dairy, no soy. Let me just read. The fat content is 4.2 for every 250 ml. Protein is 1.5. Carbohydrate is 1, where sugar is 0.7. The natural sweetener that is in here is erythritol and stevia. Okay, so that's the 1%, or yeah, 1% sugar, whatever it is. So that's the sweetener that's in this thing. And I put this in my coffee, in my bulletproof coffee, as opposed to milk. So I brew some coffee. And then milk, and I put about 10 grams of butter in it to make it bulletproof. Okay, I also do intermittent fasting. I don't eat anything or drink anything with calories until around about 10 o'clock in the morning, and my last meal of the day is about 7 p.m. So I do like 15 hours of fasting in between that. So yeah. Get rid of carbs, shop for keto-friendly food. I've got like a kilo of sauerkraut, which is pickled cabbage mostly, that I use for fiber. And I also have some jalapeno pickles to add some flavor to that. What else? So that's the next thing. The third thing, like I said, is intermittent fasting. But intermittent fasting, that's something that I've been doing for a while now. I don't really get hungry anymore. Sometimes I can go as late as 12 noon, which would be about 17 hours of fasting. Yeah. And then the fourth thing that I do is I measure and weigh myself. I am not normally somebody who would care about the weight thing. I'm more on the measurement. But I just wanted to have like a benchmark on where I've started. So, and then I keep track of my progress. I take pictures of myself as I get smaller. The thing that tells me that I'm succeeding is how my clothes fit. Like I said, because I do a lot of like activities, like I've taken on cycling. I've got a battle rope right there in the balcony and a punching bag. I've got some weights here, my gym ball. And also, yeah, so I do quite a bit of stuff. I include some badminton in there as well. So there's a lot of activity. So I don't, like I said, I don't weigh myself because I build muscles when I work out, because I do some kind of like weight training as well, strength training. So, and I know that muscles are more compact, but are heavier as opposed to fat. So I'm not really that concerned about weight. What I'm more concerned about is the measurements of my arms, of my waist, of my chest, of my thighs, of my hips. And that tells me like what I'm doing well. And when I can see a little bit of my abs right now, it's just flab, right? So that's number four, I weigh myself. And then number five is progress pictures, just to keep me accountable to myself. And I probably will show you guys that after a month. I'm restarting, I'm not sure when this video is coming up, but I'm restarting keto very strictly from the 1st of October, which is also the beginning of the Great Cycle Challenge, which I signed up for. It's a charity cycling challenge that aims to help raise funds for research on kids' cancer. So yeah, if you actually wanna help me on that and make a donation, I'm gonna leave the link in the description box down below. But I aim to cycle about 100 kilometers in the month of October and raise about $500 so that I can donate that to the Great Cycle Challenge, who is then donating it to cancer research here in Australia. So, doing my bit for charity as well as trying to, well, summer's approaching here in Australia. It's already October. 2 more months and it'll be summer. So I need to get into that summer body. All right. So that's what I'll be doing, and that's my prep list for keto. If you guys want to join me, please let me know what you're doing and how you're doing it. I'm also going to leave some links of resources for that I use for keto, and also some Instagram accounts that I follow, just in case you're interested in some recipes or transformation stories and stuff like that to keep you motivated. All right? Join me in this challenge.